And maybe for the second time, when these two DNA molecules undergoes replication, at that time, two DNA molecules getting duplicated into four DNA molecules. Okay. Yeah, two are getting duplicated into four. And the four DNA molecules are going to be used. All the four DNA molecules you are going to find viral genes. These are supposed to be the viral genes. Okay, next, what happens is after some time the virus, the DNA of the virus getting separated from the DNA of the bacteria. Okay, here maybe the cleavage occurs. Because of that cleavage, what happens is the DNA belongs to the virus getting separated from that of bacterial DNAs. Assume that these are the bacterial DNAs. Now these bacterial DNAs are get rid of the viral DNAs. Now the viral DNAs are independent. These are all viral DNAs. So as usually the viral DNAs takes the control of the host somehow. What they do is they are going to synthesize the materials they want. Of course, what the viral DNAs want? Viral DNAs, they want their proteins. If at all virus is going to be constructed, not only the nucleic acid such as DNA is essential, apart from DNA, even proteins are also essential. Of course, here DNA molecules are there, but no protein molecules present. That's why protein molecules need to be synthesized in the host cell. After all, to synthesize the viral proteins, what are necessary? I already told you, for the synthesis of any protein, there must be an mRNA present. On this messenger RNA, there is a coded message present for the synthesis of a protein. Now, these viral DNA molecules are going to synthesize their mRNAs. Okay. Their mRNAs are going to be produced now. Okay. Once their mRNAs are produced, what happens? Okay, these mRNAs are getting associated themselves with the ribosomes. They go and fix to the ribosomes. Or ribosomes may come in search of the mRNA. Finally, they find their association with each other. Once the ribosomes and mRNA are going to integrate with one another, protein synthetic machinery becomes ready. Now, what happens is, based on the coded message that is present in the mRNA, amino acids are getting assembled. As a result of that, okay, synthesis of viral proteins takes place there in the host cell. These are supposed to be the viral proteins. Next, as usually what happens is an assembly between DNA and proteins of the virus takes place. Look here. Say that this is the bacterial cell. Maybe these are supposed to be the bacterial DNAs, the schedule. and these are supposed to be the DNAs of the viruses. Cell. These are DNAs of viruses. Now the viral proteins, so being synthesized, they accumulate around the DNA of the virus. When the accumulation of these proteins takes place, what happens? Because of that accumulation, a bacterial phase may be constructed. Okay, because of the accumulation of these proteins, the new bacterial phase virus comes into existence. Here also we have this proteins as an accumulates. New bacterial phases are going to be constructed. These are supposed to be the new bacterial phases. Maybe the lambda phase, what we call it. Lambda phase is one such virus it reproduces like this. It reproduces usually with the lysogenic cycle. Now, where is this? What happens is there must be a formation of a pore in the cell wall, and through that pore, these viruses are released. Once they are released, they go in search of the host cell. By chance, if they come across a specific host cell through the interaction of amino group and carboxyl group, they are going to attach with one another. Once the attachment becomes successful, then only infection occurs. Through the infection, okay, the viruses are able to send their DNA to the host cell. Now, this DNA can't multiply independently. I just told you, it integrates with the bacterial DNA or host cell DNA. Once it integrates with the host cell DNA, now replication occurs. As and when the replication of the host cell DNA occurs, along with that, DNA of the virus also duplicates. Later, this DNA of the virus getting separated, it directs the synthesis of what you call as the mRNA. mRNA produces the viral proteins. Next, assemblies between the viral proteins and the DNA of the virus takes place, so that what happens, new viruses are constructed. Again, by the breakdown of the cell wall, the newly produced viruses, such as bacterial phages, comes out. Maybe they find some other host cell attached to the host cell. Like this, the cycle continues. And the difference is, the lysogenic cycle, the DNA of the virus do not duplicate independently. It duplicates upon integrating itself with the host cell DNA. Okay. I hope it is clear. In the next class, I am going to take up the topic, that is fungi. With this, I completed the topic viruses. Later, I am going to give the notes on this particular topic. You have to read the notes. In addition to that, you have to refer the textbooks also. I had already given you the list of textbooks to be referred. Okay, please go through that. And in the meantime, for your examination, questions may be asked on this. Explain lytic cycle of the virus. Explain lysogenic cycle of the virus. Like that, 5 mark questions may be asked. Okay, in that case, you need to write this cycle and you have to explain the elements. Okay. By chance, if you have any doubts, maybe some of the things that I have explained may not be clear to you. Through the interaction that we are going to do with the Google Meet, you can solve your doubts, you can solve your queries. Okay, till then, goodbye. Thank you.